Hi guys, it's Wednesday, I think, and ooh, look how shiny my forehead is. It's very hot in here. Today we're going to hop back into ZBrush, and gonna see how Scolla is faring. And I was also thinking of doing a little bit of Photoshop work. Here's Mr. Scolla. You guys let me know if anything is weird with the audio, if you can't hear my mouth making sounds, or if the music is too loud or whatever. Push up ZBrush a little bit so menus can be seen and such. If it will let me. On this 4K monitor, I find that I actually don't usually want it to fill up the whole screen anyway. Old leftover Intuos. What is this one? 4. It's not that old. Which I was reminded that I should be putting the hardware that I use down under my Twitch stream. There's room for widgets and such, and I just threw some in that I need to clean up and make good. Okay, I think I feel like I got Scolla pretty much done. Well, it looks like he needs scales on his legs. This hand, I don't need that one any longer. Alright, now I just need to remember, where did I put those scales? I'm guessing what I did was I used standard brush with a drag rectangle, and I'll bet I made some Scolla bumps. And if I was smart, I saved them in the Scolla folder. However, I'll bet you I was not smart, and they are not in there. They are not. Okay, which means I put them probably in alpha. Maybe skin, because it was a dummy and thought, oh, I might use this for anything, so I should put it in my folder with all the things. Let's see, and then would I have been smart enough to name it Scolla? I think I made a couple of them. Okay, maybe they're in scales. Let's check the old scale folder. Wouldn't it be nice if you could see previews of Photoshop documents? I think there is a way. There's some kind of plugin you can get, but I don't know what it is. Scolla bumps! Yay! Alright, so here's one kind of Scolla bump. Let's see what that looks like. Yep. That's what Scolla bump one looks like. Not bad. If you guys want to know how I did this, you'll have to go to my YouTube channel and go back in the history of my streams, and somewhere I will have those. Let's see. Import the other one. Scroll up. homes too. Sorry for the background noise too, we have to have the AC on. It's just redonkulously hot right now for Washington State. It's Washington State hot. It's not anywhere else hot. It's probably like 85. Ooh, I like this one. Man, good job, Past Josh. You did a good job making these alphas. Okay, let's try number three. Third time's charm. Even though I like the past two, so this one's gonna be just knock your socks off. Incredible. Okay, it looks like this one I made, I think I remember now, I made the smaller one, and then I like rotated and scaled it around a bit to make this one that can just cover more area, more faster. Yeah. All right. Done practicing. As you can see, those areas I was doing, you can't really see. What I forgot to do, I forgot to post a thing. Let me just make a thing real quick. Here we go. In progress, Scolla. And with that, I can now go to my various social media platforms. Sorry, I should have done this before, but failed so many things. How do you post a picture? That's what I need to do. Foot. Work in progress. Scolla. Streamies. ZBrush work tonight. And one thing that drives engagement is asking a question, but I don't feel like coming up with a question right now. So, engagement will not be driven. Not tonight, darn it. Gotta Twitter it as well. Guys, there's too many social medias. Oh, and I forgot. I've already sent this tweet. Forgot to add the picture. Okay. Sorry about that, everyone. Back to work. Back to the old grindstone. Okay. Where were we? We're making a Scolla. Oh, one of the things I was doing was squashing his scales, pressing his quills down a bit so that when they're 3D printed, they don't print all wonky and or snap off immediately. It looks like I definitely want to be doing some cleanup of some of these scales where it just kind of gets blurry between the stamps. But hey, one thing at a time. Stop distracting me, you guys. Let's probably need to see for scale. Whoa. Both. Both scale and scale. I need to see how big to scale these scales. So on the body, they're about that big. On the hand, they get quite a bit finer. And of course, the legs will probably start out, let's see, I'm going to say about this big. And then by the time they get down to the little toe nubbins, it can be like this big. No, actually, even smaller. Now I can solo them. Ridges, and they're not going to be. Wait, that's not a small one. It's 3, 2. 2 is the small one. Yeah, fit that between the little toe creases without getting all the distortion. Have a thing displaying art up there. I wonder how I broke it. Oh. Scared it away. Yeah, I did. When I added a thing, what did it add? Add a new source to your scene. Keep doing it, and nothing happens. Alright, I give up. Figure it out off screen later. And hi, Aletha. How's it going?
Hi, Aletha.
Heather says hi, Aletha. Africa is going to be my first serious attempt at 3D printing. Got a couple little tests I need to do as well, but I want to make a miniature, couple inch tall version of the full guy, and then and want to print like a bust size version of his head for the book cover. I feel like these feet are too, maybe not. Maybe they're the right bumpiness. Yes, mini Scollas would be great. I could do a Scolla and Sinoni couple. I want to make accessories for them so you can put their little sunglasses on. And maybe an egg sack. Oh, I should make Sinoni have a removable Dridian egg attached to her. That requires an X-Acto knife to cut it off. Spoiler alert. Pethrum, hello, welcome. How's you going? Alita, think how cool it would be. It could be like a Cadbury egg where it's actually got like gooey white gunk in it, so when you cut it off it spurts all over the place. I've been doing okay. Put the run around. Just kind of chugging along. Really looking forward to the point in my life where I can focus on one thing at a time. That looks like it's still going to be several years off, but I get closer every day, I think. At least I tell myself that. Pethrum. Okay. But there's no E there. Instead of the E being silent, the silence is an E. Is that how that works? It's really fun sculpting the little convolutions around the scales. Thank you. One thing I gotta say is thank the gods of pixel logic for having radial symmetry instead of having to do 6, 12, 24, 30. Instead of doing 32 toes, I only have to do 6. Probably did that math wrong. That's 6 times 4. Is that 32? You guys see I got a new tip cup. Isn't it pretty? In theory, if I understood what Damon was explaining to me yesterday, every time anyone does anything that I've put a checkbox on, like subscribe, give a tip, what are the other things? Cheers? Wait, I don't know. There's a variety of things. A different little icon McDealy falls into the cup. And I was trying to figure out, I want a way to customize the art of what those little McDealys are that fall in. So I think I have a way to do that. Yes, it is a beautiful tip. 24 is 4 times 6. Okay. I don't have to do 24 toes. Thanks to the fine men and women at Pixelogic. But I just get... Pethrum is following. Thanks, Pethrum. Did it drop a thing? I don't see a thing. Supposed to drop a thing, like a little comment supposed to like fly across it and then bloop. Aletha, have you followed Bonsai Baby? I feel like you'd really like her and her work. She does mostly wood carving and stuff, but she's just a really fun person and makes funny, fun things. Have not followed her yet, I suggest. I met her at a Twitch picnic barbecue thing a couple weeks ago. Yeah, look her up. Hey Aletha, you've got good sensitive ears. What's the music volume like? So I have it at negative 18, which I think is where we decided the sweet spot was last time I was on the couch. But it seems to change from day to day. Music's good? Okay. But there is a way to hear your audio output. But I do not know what it is. Sigrid, hey, good morning. Shayla and my sister's bunker. They'll be trying to talk about something secret in another room across the house with the door closed, and I can still hear them. That's how you keep them from plotting to kill you, right? Every time they plot, their plans are foiled. Like they can grab pretty well, and right now they just look kind of stumpy, so I think I need to make the scales between them quite a bit finer to give that impression. Your short story is published. Woo! How long did your short story end up being, like word count wise? And also, post a link in the comments. Little over 9,000 words. Pop this up for people watching later on YouTube. You guys can go search for this if you want to see Alita Baki's latest book. You scribbled the cover? Ooh. Media talent. I started my rewriting of the action scenes. I decided to start with the cave shroom scene because that was the most nerve-wracking one to me. And so far, actually moving the dialogue around, I feel like, solves 90% of the problem. Very front-loaded. There's like half a chapter of Glowmark talking to Sinoni about what's going on with that weird cultural thing that she's doing. And then it's just all crazy action, crazy chase scene, crazy action, crazy fight scene. And then they're out. So I just broke up that conversation that they have into several chunks and give them areas of rest between the crazy chases and fights. You don't want to shell out cash for your covers for short stories? That makes sense. We have drawings of the cave shroom structure. I did not. I kind of feel like be a really good idea, though. There'll be a map, because there's a map at the beginning of every chapter, so there'll be like a two-dimensional map at least. And then I'd also like to have a few illustrations that I'll probably like block out in ZBrush. Yeah, that reminds me. I need to figure out how to render line drawing style. Every time I try, I fail. It's like, ZBrush actually has these, like these kind of shaders that you could put on that kind of help make it look like an illustration. But they're still. Maybe what I need to do is render out one in that and then one in the other way, because this doesn't receive lighting at all, so you can't get a super good idea of the form with that shader. There's a variety of them. But yeah, I need to look into that. Oops. Anyway, yeah, thanks for reminding me about that. Something I want to do. I'm close to being done. Oh, that reminds me, did I finish these cans? I hadn't put the final texture on the palms. I think because I was waiting to finish the feet so I could just do it all together. It's a cute cover, isn't it? I mean, it communicates very well what's going on there. Where these wrinkles on the bottom of the leg are kind of colliding with the wrinkles on the bottom of the butt. do not have four-sided symmetry on body, but that's probably okay. Do a little customization, a little asymmetry down here. It's always nice to have wherever you can get it. Got a spray method for this, did I? Nope, I'm gonna spray it. When I say it, don't spray it. That works totally fine for down here. just easy to just lightly spread this over all these areas that are kind of sparse. That'd be nice. Fan of transition from there just to these tiny ones. How do I make this song go away forever? Where are you, song? No, you're in here. Can't hide forever. Starts with a T. You seem to be alphabetized. LOPQRSTU. V. Okay, there's V, 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 V. U. Hit L. Okay, it's not alphabetized. But still. Oh, there it is. Okay. Precious Ashar. There you are. Okay. Select you. Now this is going to delete my whole playlist, like it sometimes does. Delete from playlist. Aha! That's how it fooled me before. No! What are you doing? Gosh, I'm so good at computers, you guys. You guys ever need me to do tech stuff, for your computer, just let me know. I'm super good. Yeah, Damon survived. I let him out of the basement eventually. Give Shane a cow skull. Wow, now he's got three cow skulls. Just what he needs to help him succeed in life. Occurred to me that I wrote a scene where it appears that Sinoni dies, which is a great way to build dramatic tension, but I resolve it almost immediately, like within two sentences. I should probably play that up. I'm just saying that out loud, so I'll remember when I work on it tonight. McKeown, how's it going? How is ZBrush versus Maya? They're used for pretty different purposes. So, I wouldn't really versus them. ZBrush is very much for sculpting, and Maya is very much for modeling and animation and rendering. If you want to compare particular features, like the rendering in Maya versus the rendering in ZBrush, or that sort of thing, I suppose you could do that, but there's certainly the sculpting capability in Maya doesn't even come close to touching what ZBrush does, and then the things that Maya can do that ZBrush can't do, ZBrush doesn't do very well. At least not for me. They've included modeling features, but they're so weird and unintuitive. People who take the time to build up the muscle memory and use the modeling features, do amazing things for sure. But I am not one of those people. You only use Maya for basic movie making. Movie making? What kind of movies do you make in Maya? Like CG ones? animation shorts. Okay. Yeah, you cannot make an animation short in ZBrush. Well, you probably could, but it would be very bad. Piling up the little scales around the quills help. Maybe. Although probably more helpful would be doing an actual, let's see. So building up the flesh a little bit. Puckering it around the nodules. It's always good to pucker around nodules. It's a general good life skill there. Of that, aren't I? Bump that intensity a little bit. How am I going to have to do that on all of them? I'm already pretty deeply embedded. I'm getting kind of a little hood that goes over them is probably going to help keep them grounded, not just floating bits and bobs. Something scratching my tablet. McKeon, do you have any links to your animation shorts that we should check out? actually want to play up the... Let's see, the way these quills kind of pin up the folds and wrinkles. Probably the more the better. I don't know. Experimenting. Haven't done it in a few years. Lost them all in a hard drive crash. No. That is awful. Sculptress Pro, this guy. Yes, I can. I probably should have checked. Did a whole Dynamesh on him last time. So everything was very, very consistent topology wise. I made the topology a little tighter. These bumps show up better, and as they go out to the rest of the body, they're more pixelated. That's fine because, you know, I'm going to be looking at it from back here, and you will not see a difference. Stretch there. Probably not gonna work too well. The scales kind of keep things from flexing too much. Since kids, my creative works have fallen to basically nil. Oh, tell me about it. Once we got Faith, but my youngest just turned 19 a couple days ago, so they are no longer blocking me. In fact, Shane is actually working on learning the skills he's going to need to actually help me. Editing videos and stuff like that, so that's pretty exciting. That's like back in the day when farmers would have kids so they can have farm hands, but with computer stuff. Kids make for great dialogue ideas. Yeah. You know what they say, kids say the darndest things. It's definitely true. Well, this is, there's more work on here than I thought there was. And I'm pretty tired tonight. I think I'm gonna call it a little bit early. But have no fear. We're gonna get this guy done. I'm gonna power through it. I'm almost done with my commission, and that'll free me up to focus like a laser on this. So we'll be getting this probably printed out fairly soon. That's gonna be exciting. I'm gonna be photographing Bowmark pretty soon. I'll probably stream that process. I've never streamed a photography session, so that should be fun. Yeah, so we'll see you guys on Sunday. If I'm super diligent, I'll have done a lot of this boring grunt work before then. But you know how I am with being super diligent. McKeon says, my kids are just getting old enough now and getting interested in making things. That's always fun, seeing the stuff they're thinking. Thinking about getting into 3D printing. Yes, the more people doing it, the better. Make it less of a weird technical hobby that only technical people can do. Save this puppy. All right, yeah, so thanks a lot for stopping by, everyone. And yeah, sorry for the short stream, but sometimes you gotta balance. You gotta balance things. So I'm balancing right here, right now. See you guys all later on Sunday. Bye.